now we are going to discuss about the anterior examination of the obstetric muscles. So as I have already discussed theory before, we have inspection, superficial palpation, and then after that we need to feed the fetus, pelvic maneuver, then after that auscultation. So first inspection, you need to have a look the pregnant abdomen properly. And then, okay, what do we need to have a look? We need to see whether the abdomen is grossly distended, any cutaneous signs of pregnancy, such as linea nigra, striae gravidarum, and then striae albicans of previous pregnancy. And then see any visible fetal movement. Sometimes if you see the visible fetal movement, you can see that there is a fetal movement is seen. And then after that, you need to rule out any previous scar in the suprapubic area, either here or any of the scars, like laparoscopy scar, appendectomy scar, any of the surgical scar is important for the patient. If you see a scar, then you have to describe. There is a surgical scar seen in the suprapubic area, then you need to do the measurement. You need to measure. It is about 12 centimeter in length and it is bulky, right? Okay, so after you have done the proper inspection, then you need to present. So on inspection, abdomen is grossly distended by pelvic uterus as evidenced by linea nigra, striae gravidarum, and then striae albicans. Umbilicus is centrally located and inverted. And then there is no surgical scar seen and no visible fetal movement seen. And no other scar or no other dilated lesion. Right? And after that, superficial palpation or light palpation. The main reason for superficial palpation is you need to rule out any of the acute abdominal condition. For example, during pregnancy, like chorioamnionitis or any of the scar rupture, uterine rupture, etc. Right? So superficial palpation, you need to ask the patient first, is there any area that you are having pain? If she is having pain in the lower abdomen, then you need to start palpation from the area far away from pain. Then you need to check all the quadrants of the abdomen and look at the patient's face as well. Okay, on superficial palpation, abdomen is soft and untender, and uterus is not good. Uterine irritability, it means that there is an infection ongoing, like chorioamnionitis. Irritable uterus is when you touch, the uterus will contract. This is called irritability. When you stop touching it, uterus will relax. It is different from contraction and relaxation. It's contraction and relaxation, it doesn't matter whether you touch or you don't touch. It will have the contraction relaxation ongoing. But uterine irritability means irritable means when you go and provoke something, then it will become irritable, isn't it? When you touch the abdomen, it will become contract. It's called irritability. So you have to rule out after doing the superficial palpation, there is no uterine irritability. After that, you need to do that. What is the next step? Symphysiophantal height and angle. So first, you have to start from the symphysiophantal. From the CP standard, you can go either this way or either this way. So CP standard is normally empty, isn't it? Then you go down. And then you stop where you feel the first resistance. This is the fundus of the uterus. So fundus of the uterus, then you will measure from the 10 centimeter should be down now, because you don't want bias. Then you copy the symphysis pubis bone. Then you see, this is a 37 centimeter. So symphysis of the height is 37 centimeter. And then clinical fundal height also the same. So normally, at the level of umbilicus is how many weeks? around 20 weeks. One finger above the umbilicus, 22 weeks. One finger below the umbilicus is 18 weeks. So 20 weeks, then clinically you can add like one finger is equal to 2 weeks. Or you can do like a quadrant, like 4 parts, you can divide into 4 parts. If it's done up, I will consider as 36 weeks. And umbilicus is 20 weeks. So if we divide into 4 parts, then you can add 4 weeks each. So here is 20, 24, 28, 32, and 36. After 36 weeks, baby is going to be engaged, going down for the baby, isn't it? So from the height will be higher or lower? Lower. But the baby is getting bigger, isn't it? So the flank from here become full with the baby. When the baby is still small, baby is only at the center. But now baby is already turned 37 weeks, so it is coming down for the delivery, but it will grow bigger. So when you feel the subcostal margin, you will feel the fullness because the baby is there. Right? So clinically, now it is coming down one finger below the sternum, but the flank becomes full. Then it is around 38 weeks, 38 to 40 weeks. Alright, this is a clinical MRI. Just now we did the same thing. Then after that, what is the next step? Fungal grip, natural grip, and pelvic grip. So fungal grip, we need to see, we need to feed the fungus. And then I can feel one hole here. Then lateral grip. Lateral grip. And you have to feel the left lateral and right lateral grip. So first I want to feel the left lateral. Then I will stabilize my left hand, the right side of the mother, and I feel the left side of the mother. You cannot move your hand together, you won't feel anything. So one hand stabilized, you feel one side. After that, you push the baby towards that side, stabilize, and then you feel it. And you have to decide which one has more curve and which one has the small fetal parts. So here, I will say that left side is the fetal spine, more curve. Maternal right side has the fetal parts, small fetal parts. So we have done the fungal grip, lateral grip. Now we have to do the pelvic grip. Then we need to turn to the opposite side of the mother. Then we will go to the pelvis of the mother. And then we will feel a left pole is that. So I can feel another pole here. So now I have to. So since I can feel one pole in the fundus and I can feel another pole in the pelvis. What lie is that? What is the fetal lie? It's a longitudinal line because one pole here, another pole here is a normal longitudinal line. So now in the longitudinal line, it can be a cephalic presentation, it can be a rich presentation. So now we need to decide which one is head and which one is cephalic. Then how do we decide? Okay, head is a smaller and palatable and harder. The buttock is a soft and broad and not palatable. So practically, how can we decide, how can we differentiate this? It's quite obvious, head is quite hard. It's a lot harder than the buttock. Then, head is very small. Here, this is one pole here. Right. And then the fundus, this is one pole. So, definitely the fundal pole is bigger. Right, and here this is the one pole, it's smaller. And then when you feel in the rear patient, rear baby as well, the head is a lot harder than the buttock. So sometimes you will see a patient with a very thick abdominal wall, very difficult to palpate. don't know which one is head, which one is buttock. Then you can differentiate like which one is smaller, which one is bigger, and which one is harder, and which one is softer. This is practically very useful. Right? So now I can say that this is the head, is in the pelvis because it is a soft, it is a hard, small and palatable. So baby is in a longitudinal line, decorative presentation. Then after that, so after we have done the palpation, then I will conclude that the fetus is a single fetus because it's only one fetus to go, longitudinal line, cephalic presentation, and fetal bed is on the maternal left side. Then ligo volume is clinically adequate because if it is a ligo volume is excessive, the abdomen will be grossly distended, uterus larger than date, and you cannot feel the fetal pole during the fetal pass very well if it is polyhydramnios. If it is only polyhydramnios, less ligo, then you may feel that abdomen will be, uterus will be smaller than date, and then you can feel the fetal pass very well. Then it is an only polyhydramnios. Now it looks like it's quite normal. Then after that, auscultation. So auscultation of the fetal heart, how would you auscultate? Where do you auscultate? Anterior shoulder of the baby. So this is a pinna stethoscope, and you have to place it with a pinna stethoscope. So now, left side or right side? Where do we? Where do you put the your stethoscope? Pinna stethoscope. Here or here? Left side. Why?
It's behind.
Because the spine is here. Then you put it here.